perception at least is that the underlying model is more or less the same as the your canvas and our service.
It's very much a similar approach, and it's the approach that we see in many cases in terms of building up layers of information about an object. Sorry. Again, I was just echoing that yes, we definitely are aware of the TEI approach. This approach is also seen in such spaces as even building up a PowerPoint deck. So the idea of a blank canvas is something that is sort of out there. What we're implementing and what's different, I think, from the TEI is that we are simply interested in the display and discoverability aspects in a linked data approach. Which means that we can point to or be pointed to by any TEI document. And indeed, we build our manuscript descriptions off of TEI. Many of the transcriptions are built off of the TEI. But the TEI doesn't deal with terribly well our infinitely or semi-infinitely cited sections of the canvas. So if we want to point to a very irregular space on a canvas and say something about that, the TEI doesn't handle that elegantly. The TEI also doesn't work well with building up multiple types of heterogeneous information about an object. And so what we envision and the way that we see working together with TEI and other standards is having the TEI be perhaps one layer of annotation among many types of annotations. So multiple images built up into a space, into a discoverable and viewable space, transcriptions in TEI, perhaps manuscript descriptions in TEI, comments that could be in plain text, media fragments, music, video, etc., all that aren't necessarily handled terribly well by the text encoding initiative. But we certainly didn't want to do anything that would stop the TEI from being used or interoperable with what we're doing. So in essence, what we're using is the canvas as a space to build up many different types of information about the object.
I mean, you have the TEI as surfaces, and you have the canvas. First of all, one question, what is a canvas? Is it just a loop coordinate?
Yes, it's an aspect ratio. Simply an aspect ratio with the URI.
So it's kind of positions on the imaginary image? Or?
I'd say that one.
I mean, it's the idea with the canvas that they have coordinates to which you can add information.
Yes, in fact, it's an aspect ratio so that you can stretch it or stretch images to it, but then you can attach bits of text as well to a portion of that. If you scale that canvas up, the text then remains in essentially the same place, so that if you overlay a larger image, the text still appears in the same place.
So the next question is that you have a canvas and you have a surface, which I don't think you have the TEI has done, but if you have a three-dimensional object, what do you do?
Yes, that's a very good question, and if you have some ideas about how to approach that, we would love to talk with you about it. We've looked somewhat at ivories and other flat three-dimensional objects, but we haven't explored the three-dimensionality of these materials in a very good way. We've simply dealt with the flat facts and ways at the moment.
Just one question, how do you deal with the annotations or pieces on the canvas? Do you have assisted identifiers? Or
yes.
So they are independently accessed?
Yes, each annotation, sorry to repeat that, the question was how do we deal with the annotations, and each resource that we deal with gets its own unique identifier, so that what we do then when we rebuild all of the information about the canvas is pull together all of the identifiers